So I have some great videos for you today. Some Town Hall 10 3-star queen walks, the difference between 2-star and a 3-star attack. This is a 3-star attack for me, both of them for me. And so let's break it down. Let's see how it's going to go. So my plan was to drop the queen in the south and let her queen walk hopefully towards the east. So I planned that she go towards the east. And then I drop my golem at that kind of wizard tower and between the wizard tower and archer tower in the east and do the wizards. That way the Valkyries would path right towards the core of the base on towards those Inferno towers. Now, before I went in for the attack, I also planned, in case the queen drifted to the west, if she walked to the west, I also had that plan of attack as well. It's always good to be prepared no matter what you face, and if that happened, I would do pretty much the same thing. Let the queen in, I would bring wall breakers, they would hit the right on that cannon, so they'd take out the queen would take out the air defense, and then the golem near that archer tower. And the reason I came from the south is, with the queen walk, it's away from the expos. Try to get away from the expos as far as possible so you won't have to use as many rage if possible. So this is the game plan. Let's see how it plays out. Now, I dropped the queen towards the south, and because of this army camp there, I thought, hey, she's definitely going to pass to the right, without a doubt. But as you can see, she is going how I predicted at first. She's going to hit the archer tower, and then I think she's going to hit the barracks, and then she's going to go, I think, for the army camp. So at this point, I was like, okay, she's going to hit the wizard tower, then maybe shift back towards the cannon, the mortar, I mean. But what she does, she goes towards the west. So, okay, I had planned for this. I wasn't freaking out at this moment. I knew what I had to do, so I continued with my development of the troops. Those wall breakers are huge there. I brought enough because if the queen, if the air defense had locked onto my healers, I knew it would have been a fail. It would have been much harder to win this attack. So the golem actually is doing business. I am making the funnel exactly how I want it. And soon I'm about to drop the king, and I'm a little late on the Valkyries. The king actually takes a lot of more damage than I was hoping. I should have dropped the Valkyries first, I think. The king took too much damage, put the jump spells down. I brought two jump spells because I knew I needed the Valkyries to get over these defensive walls because it was a compartmentalized base. I froze the opposite side Inferno Tower because the first Inferno Tower was taken out so quickly. I didn't bring a heal. I didn't need a heal. I didn't have hogs or any of that stuff. The reason I didn't bring hogs is, like, if for some reason my attack didn't go well, at least I would have probably gotten the 2-star. So I tried for the 2, was hoping for the 3, and as you can tell, luckily, the healers actually stuck on my king a little bit. They're dead now, but they stuck on the king just a little bit to regain his health. And the queen is still up with her royal ability. I knew it was over from the beginning. Tons of Valkyries left, so perfectly executed attack for the 3-star. So now, stick around, guys. Stick around. You need to know what happens when you don't 3-star, when you 2-star, and what's the main difference. So this is against the Town Hall 11. Yes, it's not a max Town Hall 11. It's not even a max Town Hall 10. But it does have the Expos, the Infernos, those max heroes, which I don't have max heroes. So I knew this would be an uphill battle. Plus those walls. Walls are so huge. And as you can tell, in this attack, it's actually going to lose. So my plan was to start the queen on this side. Hopefully she would take out the enemy queen and path down toward the south. I would then drop my golem near that wizard tower with the archers. And most of the Valkyries would pass through that air defense and the gold storage, as you can see there. And then they'll go into the core and hit the both Infernos. So I put her over here. I was like, hey, she is definitely going to path south. Only level 28 hero, queen, so I knew it was going to be tough in the beginning. I was like, I only brought 3 healers. Like, I cannot use her ability so soon. I was like, hold on. Luckily, she was able to take down that archer queen. I mean, the archer tower. But look, so after this, I thought, hey, she's going to path south. But no, she passed north. I did not plan for this at all. So I was freaking out. I was like, okay, I got to make split second decisions. I'm going to think in the moment. I'm going to, okay, I'm going to funnel and bring my golem, kind of what I do on the other side, on the west side, but now this is the east. So calling a total audible here in the moment. So I'm going to about to drop my golem here soon, And actually, it kind of worked out well for me. The queen was able to take out a lot of defensive units. Here comes the golem, gonna create the funnel and the spread. About to drop the wall breakers off to the side from the wizard tower. Very important, guys. Don't drop the wall breakers with the same where the wizard tower is hitting, or else you'll lose them. So things are going well at first. Okay, hey, this is it. The funnel is here. Clan castle's coming out. Dragons. I knew it was dragon. Someone had already scouted this base for me. I dropped some poisons, but look, I was like, I don't need to drop my queen's ability. She's got this. Wrong decision. I should have clicked the button. I was too greedy. Too greedy at all. So I dropped the freeze. Big first mistake there. I should have dropped the freeze on the opposite side. It would have taken out the Inferno Tower and those two expos. Way too much damage being done. Big mistake on my part. And look what happened. If the queen, if I popped her ability, I actually would have three-starred this base. Because look at my healers. They actually went too far into the core. Those air defenses are taking them down. And I just don't have enough time and the troops left to get this three-star. What really slowed me down was those walls. You don't think walls play a role in Clash of Clans? They sure do. They slowed my Valkyries down so much that I couldn't get the three-star. I would have gotten the three-star if there was enough time. I have three Valkyries and the king left and a wizard. And only one defense left, or two, counting the mortar. But there you go, ran out of time. There's the difference between two and three star attacks. I just wanted to show that to you. See you again next time. Thanks again for watching. We'll see you around. Halo out.